Today I'm diving around a 500-foot Navy shipwreck that's home to a lot of sharks. I'll be exploring this wreck inside and out to see what I can find. Good morning, guys. Well, it is another day of diving. This time I'm heading out in the morning, so I gotta get all my gear ready. Let's head on over to the dive shop. After completing a night dive just about 12 hours earlier, I was super excited to get back in the water for my first two-tank dive excursion of the trip. It's a short ride to Rainbow Reef Dive Center, where I would quickly get my gear ready for today's adventure.
All right, here we go.
Today I'm heading out to the famous Spiegel Grove wreck here in the Florida Keys. This wreck is over 500 feet in length, with multiple cranes, helipads, American flags, bridges, and so many different places to explore. This will be my third time on the wreck, but with how large it is, it's going to take a very long time to explore the whole wreck. After about a 35-minute boat ride, we finally reached the site of the Spiegel Grove. Luckily, there weren't any other dive boats here yet, which means we had the whole wreck to ourselves. I hopped in the water and started my descent. This wreck sits in deep water, 144 feet to be exact, but most of my dive would be spent around 90 feet towards the top of the ship. I followed this down line all the way to the wreck, and as it starts to come into frame, you can really see just how massive it is. This wreck also always has sharks on it, which I saw immediately with this little reef shark way off in the distance. Wrecks in deep water are kind of like an oasis, and always home to larger predators, including barracudas. The Spiegel Grove always has so many different barracudas, and although they may look scary to some, these fish typically avoid divers at all costs. I eventually made my way down to 95 feet, and this is where I could really start exploring the wreck. The amount of biodiversity down here is just crazy. There are so many different fish using the wreck as protection from larger predators in the area. And since this wreck was a dock landing ship in the Navy, there are American flags placed all over the wreck, which is a cool feature to see while underwater. As I was filming this shark right beneath me, my dive master signaled my attention because there was another Caribbean reef shark right next to me. This is a good-sized female reef shark, and I'm starting to notice that these sharks like to approach me more than everyone else in my dive group. I'm pretty sure it's because of my big camera, but I'm always down for a close shark encounter. Right afterwards, I started making my way deeper into the wreck. Here I found a lot of snappers hiding in between pieces of metal sticking up. Not only is this protection like I said earlier, but it also hides them from the current, which typically is always present on the Spiegel Grove. I then found this little passage big enough to swim through. This was my first time going deep inside the Spiegel Grove, and the inside was so cool. It looks like something out of a James Bond movie, and there's always a little bit of an eerie feeling going through the inside of a shipwreck. In a wreck of this size, it's also super easy to get lost or disoriented, so I made sure not to go too far inside of the Spiegel. Once outside, I was immediately greeted by large schools of fish. Diving to Spiegel was like going through an aquarium at times, just an insane amount of biodiversity everywhere you go. Right here, I was in 100 feet of water, the deepest so far of the day, where I was greeted by an even larger Caribbean reef shark than before, this time a male. This guy was probably around 7 to 8 feet in length, which is about as big as this species gets. At this point in the dive, the sharks were pretty much everywhere. Beneath us, behind us, and pretty much in every direction I looked. The Spiegel Grove is definitely one of the sharkiest dive sites I've been to. However, on deep dives just like this, your dive time is cut short. And after spending 30 minutes down here exploring the wreck, it was time to slowly ascend towards the surface and go to our second dive site of the day. But not before this final pass by reef shark right here. After a short surface interval, we made it to our second dive site of the day, French Reef. This is one of the best dive sites in the Florida Keys and a personal favorite of mine, so I was super excited to hop in. As I made my way down to 30 feet, I noticed how many different fish species were around me. Parrotfish, snappers, wrasse, and everything in between. You might be wondering, what the heck is this parrotfish doing? Well, sometimes they will pose like this and let cleaner wrasse come in and eat the parasites off their body. It's a really fascinating symbiotic relationship. I also noticed that in some spots the reef looked relatively healthy, while in others it seemed to be devastated by coral bleaching. This staghorn coral is supposed to be a bright orange color, but in this shot you can see it's mostly white from bleaching. Last year, water temps reached record highs in the Keys, as much as 90 degrees or more, and the effects can still be seen. As I continued, I spotted something out of the corner of my eye, a massive southern stingray. I mean, look at the size of that barb. You definitely don't want to take a sting from this guy. Shortly after, I noticed this big cloud of dust. And as I got close, another southern stingray came out of nowhere. This guy was cruising the reef around us for a while before finally heading off into the deep blue and out of sight. This right here is a Nassau grouper in about average size. These guys are typically really skittish around divers, but I was able to get face to face with this individual. I explored some more of the surrounding reef, but eventually it was time to head back up to the boat. Today was a phenomenal day out on the water, exploring one of the largest shipwrecks in the world available to divers, as well as seeing the beautiful coral reef ecosystem was just awesome. I definitely had some really cool animal encounters as well. Stay tuned to see me work with rescued sea turtles, go night diving, and catch venomous snakes in the Florida Everglades.